not that deep.
Your approval, I thirst these phonies, if you don't mind.
The only thing worth a damn in here is her.
Cindy Sherman?
Among the first of her untitled film stills.
Yeah. Cindy's great, but over $500,000 for just another 8x10 of her playing dress up.
Before this series, Sherman was just another photographer hiding behind the lens, observing, choosing subjects based on what others might like. And one day, she steps into her own frame, considers herself to be worthy, rather than being forced into a role in the male-dominated art world. She takes a leading role in her work. It changes the world. This is not dress up. This is bravery. This is a moment in art.
You must be one of Damien's galleryists.
You think I work here? I don't work.
What's wrong with working? How else will you ever be able to afford to give Cindy here a good home?
My father buys whatever I tell him to, and someday it will all go to me.
Earning it beats inheriting it.
Trust me. Trust you? The person considering buying that, thing instead of this?
I bought it, of course. Oh, of course. I liked her. So she became part of my circle. For a while. Until she showed up in Ibiza.
Ibiza? Oh, Ibiza. Right. Ibiza.
Yeah. I was there with some friends, and she and Chase had texted to let us know they were in town, except it was strange right off the bat.
Wait, stop. What the fuck is that boat? Whose feet is that?
It's Talia. She's in Ibiza.
That can't be her boat.
It's a yacht, and it's not. It's this guy's.
Fuck, Henrik Knight? That dude's huge in tech. I saw him speak at the Silicon Alley thing. I need him to invest in Wake. His endorsement could open the floodgates for investment.
Stanford, tennis player, invested in biotech, net worth $2 billion.
Text Talia.
Text her what?
Tell her we're in Ibiza.
But we're in Chelsea.
Just do it. Tell her we're there.
What? Are you serious?
Yeah.
She's answering.
What'd she say?
She invited us for dinner. Fuck, what should I tell her?
Tell her we're busy tonight. We'll come by tomorrow.
Chase.
Tell her.
What? Fuck. Okay. Okay.
She answering?
Hold on, yes. Dinner tomorrow?
We better book tickets.
No, I'm not. My father is not happy with me at the moment, so.
It's cool, I got.
Well, I'm off. Think of me in Paris working 4 runway shows in 3 days, like a normal. While you two lounge here in my life.
We're going to Ibiza.
I loathe you.
Can we even get my dinner? Go.
Hello.
Hello.
Salut.
Meeting schedule?
No meeting. I was just wondering if we're playing dirty. Because I wasn't planning on it, but here you are playing dirty, so I thought I'd warn you. This ends badly for you.
Todd, in order to feel threatened, which I believe is your intention, I have to know what you're talking about.
Discovery? You sent over a shoebox.
Lame. It wasn't a shoebox. No, it wasn't a shoebox.
Oh, I see. So I should plan on showing up to trial with 10 empty boxes for all the evidence that you'll have just magically discovered.
Everything. You sure?
End of the week.
Rachel.
Don't. She's a sweetie.
She won't visit Anna. Did you know
and if she is not ready for the real world, she is gonna get upset about the service or be herself to the wrong chick and end up with a beatdown. We cannot leave her alone in there. She needs to look forward to something. And Rachel? She acts like she barely knew Anna all of a sudden, like Anna is some stranger, as if she's new to the situation. She literally is walking in Anna's shoes as we speak. Red Bottom Spring Collection. I wish I had hair.
Okay.
I kissed Becky's face.
Stop. Good. Now, Rachel is not visiting Anna in prison. She has her reasons. But I think it's wonderful that you...
Okay. So, do you want to do visits every other week with me, or twice a week, or...
Baby. I'm setting some boundaries where Anna is concerned. I will also not be going to Rikers to see her. I'll always be here for you.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't understand. How do you just turn your back on someone?
Nev, the person in prison is not Anna Delvey. Not the person we knew. Anna Delvey doesn't exist. That person in Rikers is somebody else. Somebody who was pretending to be Anna Delvey. We don't know her. You don't know anything about her.
She's Anna.
She may be your friend, Anna. Or she may be a total stranger. Do you really want to go down there, walk into that prison, and find out the person you thought was one of your closest friends was just a made-up character?
Was just throw of you?
What's up, Anna?
What? I have no idea.
Sorry, thought I caught a little rusty in your accent.
Oh.
To your health. I did a year in Moscow during college. The only thing I remember is the toasts. You? You, my dear.
Cheers.
A little sloppy.
Cheers. We're here.
You made it. Cheers.
I don't know how you do it, Talia. Working sucks. I just want to follow the party year round while those bozos figure out a way to pay for it. You know what I mean, Anna. So where's next? Well, Stevie, thanks for
that. Data is the new time.
Trying to kill me.
Yes, but it's dream data.
Subjective.
And honestly, it sounds about as valuable as, well, dreams, which, I mean, what's a bigger waste of time than sitting and listening to someone tell you their dreams?
Totally. It's the worst. It's a small part.
Basel in Miami.
We're in the
big thing.
We're harvesting massive amounts.
God, Jason's working so hard on this applicant. He's so shameless. He's just really passionate about this. Sure, and that's great and all, but we're on vacation.
He needs to chill.
Yeah. Ed, come on. Let's dance.
Just to put the dog.
Chase, enough with the shop talk.
Hen, hold on. Quick question. How old are you? Late 50s?
About that, yeah. Why?
No, I'm just curious what the age is when you draw the line. I mean, a lot of what you just said and your whole attitude. My father said the same things to me back in high school when I told him to invest in Facebook.
Well, I have a telephone. Why wouldn't I just call my friends?
But really, what he meant was, I'm smarter than you, little girl, and it's impossible that I'm not right. Add a dash of misogyny to that attitude, and boom, you two can lose $100 million, just like that.
Which isn't a problem for him, obviously. He's doing just fine.
Well, so is my father. The money is not the point. The question's bigger than that. You know, I wonder, is it that the closer you are to death, the more sure you need to be about life, about the stuff you know or you think you know? Because it can be scary to get old. Is it?
Mm-hmm.
This combo is really bumming me out.
Yeah, let's all just...
What not? Because I can relate. I'm scared about what to do with my life, so I avoid the question. Try to outrun it. But it haunts me. Does death haunt you?
Anna, stop.
You are a
it's
guest.
Fine.
My guest.
I can handle it.
Of course you can. And he wants to answer. Look at him.
I think about death more these days, sure. So what?
Do you have a dream about it? Do you think other people your age dream about death? The fear?
Yeah. They do.
If I'm Big Pharma, wouldn't it be valuable to know this? So I can sell you Xanax or whatever?
You're good. She's good. You say you're looking for a job?
Me? No, no. I made the pledge not to work for others. Uh-huh. You can make a pledge too. Here's the Kickstarter page for Wake. I think you get a t-shirt if he reaches his goal or something.
That's $100,000. Very generous.